Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2048, colon index will replace a volatile offset. Hey, I'm podcasting all of my tips from this book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist. All right, offset is an amazing function. Offset allows us to specify a top left corner cell and then use variables to define from there how many rows down, how many rows over, and then define a shape. All right, so here if I want to add up or do an average of, let's say, 3/4. This formula right here, we'll take a look at the formula. The offset says we're starting from B2, starting from Q1. We're going over or down 0, over 0. The shape will be one row tall and it will be H1, in other words, 3 cells wide, right? So in this case, all we're really doing is changing how many cells we're adding up. We're always starting back in B2. Or B3 or B4 as I copy down, and then it decides how many cells wide, right? Offset is this cool thing. It does all kinds of amazing functions, but here's the hassle. It is volatile, which means that even if something's not in the calculation chain, Excel is going to take the time to recalculate it, which is going to slow things down, all right? So this amazing version of index, right? Normally, if I would ask for the index of these 4 cells, comma 3, it's going to return the number 1403. However, when I put a colon either before or after the index, something very different happens. So we'll take a look at this formula here. So index of the 4 cells, which one do I want? I want the 3rd one, but you see there's a colon right there, that colon. So we're always going to add, go from B2 in this case over to D2, and I'll show you if we go to formulas, evaluate formula. All right, so right here it's going to calculate the number 3, and then here the index with the colon next to it, instead of telling us 1403, which is how index normally would calculate, it's going to return $D2, and then the average will do the average of those 3. Absolutely amazing the way that this works, and the added benefit, it is not volatile. All right, and this can even be used to replace an incredibly complex offset. So here with this offset, we're based on these values. If I choose Q2 and central, right, these formulas are using match and count up to figure out how many rows down, how many columns over, how tall, how wide, and then the offset here is using all of those values to figure out the median. We'll just do a test to make sure that it is working. So equal median of that blue range over there better be 71, all right, and we'll choose something else here, Q3 and west. All right, so press F2. I'm just going to drag this over and resize it to rewrite that formula. Press enter, and it's working with the offset. Well, here using an index, I actually have a colon in the middle with an index on the left side and an index on the right side. We'll watch this thing get calculated in evaluate formula. So it starts out, we'll evaluate, and right here that index is about to turn into a cell address. So H16 is the first west Q3. Then over on the right side, we'll evaluate, a couple more, and then right here it changes to I20. So cool way, non-volatile to replace an offset using the index function. All right, this tip and many more in this book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to buy the book. All right, recap: offset, awesome, flexible function. Once you master it, you can do all kinds of things. Point to a variable top left cell, point to a range that has a variable shape, but it's volatile, and so they calculate at every calculation. Excel usually does a smart calculation or it recalculates the cells that need to be calculated, but with offset it will always get calculated. Instead of offset, you can use index colon or colon index or even index colon index. Anytime an index has a colon next to it, it will return a cell address instead of the value of that cell, and the benefit is index is not volatile. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.